So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Liberty Flames and the Auburn Tigers.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Tigers should have an easy one tonight, Dick. How do they keep this team from sneaking up on them?
And here's my keys for them tonight. First of all, reward your big man. Give him the ball down low. Get him into the game. Let him be part of the offense. Next, win the battle on the glass. That's going to be huge tonight. Boy, that stat at the end could be a big one. Lastly, don't be passive defensively. Be the initiator and force them to do things they don't want to do offensively.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Both teams looking to get things going here. He uses the shot fake. Executes the baby hook. They still don't score. Number 32 receives the ball. He tries to knock down the three. Not there. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Leans in. Number 32 with a finger roll. Dickie's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He'll regroup the offense. Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. He lets it go. No good. Number three receives the pass. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Trying to pack it inside. Thinks about the shot. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Pass down low. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. The shooting guard handles the pass. Three scorches the net. They work the perimeter. Puts it up looking for contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. He keeps the dribble as they reset. With the fake, here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Blocks the shot.
Up it inside.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
For two, the putback. Inside for the bucket, and he missed. a bad pass right to the defender. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Number 24 is feeling great out there right now.
Hey, can you blame him, Red? He's getting it done.
Unloads. Way off target. The Tigers are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless.
Jam City, baby. That's a rib rocker.
He makes the block. Gave it up. Number 23 handles the feed. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
And Dick, the shooting woes continue from behind the arc.
Hey, that's a couple in a row now where they've come up empty.
Both teams looking to get things going here. He shoots from left of the circle. There was no doubt about that one. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Looking for the foul. He puts it in with contact and all. They'll work it around the arc. Fed the low block. You see it time and time again. Star players make plays.
Hey, Brad, he's expected to do all the things that will put them in a position to win at the end of the day.
He tries a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Dump it inside.
He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
You see, that's what happens when you go for the steal. You end up with unnecessary personal fouls.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. He buries it. Second one, no good. Inside, fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
That's a great play. What a play. Demonstrating unbelievable skill. Now look at it. He's celebrating with the cheerleaders.
Hey, I think he's missed the versatile. Play some hoop. Do a little dance.
Oh, that's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Number 21, make that bucket counts and he'll go to the line.
Hey, excellent job there, drawing the foul and finishing the hoop.
The Tigers are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. It goes in. This is great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He was guarding him tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
If you get the steal, you're a hero. But you always run the risk of committing a foul when you go for that steal.
On the outside. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Dickey really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining position because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Number one is down emotionally right now, Dick.
Hey, well, offensively, he's probably not feeling it. Defensively, he's been a step behind.
He gets the rejection. He rejects it. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
In and out.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Takes the pass in the paint for two.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn. I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle to it. It was up and under. He seals off the defensive play.
At halftime, the Flames are down by four. Liberty carelessly gave away a lot of possessions by turning the ball over.
Their coaching staff must be livid right now. The amount of extra opportunities they're giving away is just absurd.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it. He saw that developing.
He was right there when the ball left his hand. The center gets the ball. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
You bet. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. He tries the three, makes it.
Oh, right there, they missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. From downtown. Can't put it down. The point guard with the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter. Gave it up for the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
That right there is exactly what they expect from him, Dick.
Yeah, and I say it all the time. It makes life much easier when you have a guy on your roster who can make these types of plays.
On the dribble, gives it up. Those long arms trying to get it in front, three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball. He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Easy one. Moving it around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. Fakes it. Jump hook from the low block. They still don't score. Gave it up. The center takes the feed. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He shoots from right of the circle. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
A high screen. Rejected. In the paint. Goes up for two. Delay it. The Flames trail by five.
That's spacing.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Up fake. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad. Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Steals the pass. He should have an easy bucket here. For the deuce, Liberty are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they'll keep pushing and seeing if they can't force a timeout.
The toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Hey, he should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move. Stolen. Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
Andre tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you know, points in the paint is a stat that coaches will readily look at, comparing their team's dominance in this category with opposition. Establishing that inside presence is an important facet of consistent success.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down to the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. On the outside. Launches the three. Off the rim and no good. The outside. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays it where he gets good close position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately block out and get good rebound position.
Change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us here.
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops and do it now.
Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
High post flasher is open. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Around the perimeter. There's the pick. There's the roll. Off the rim and no good. There's the fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Tries for two, and he missed. Two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Takes the pass in the paint. Tries for two. He can't get the bucket to fall. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, right at the eye, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
A double team. Try to come up with a steal, and they do. Moving it around the perimeter. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. He tries the three ball. Rims out. The point guard takes the pass. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. And the ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Fakes the shot. The point guard gets the pass. Kicks it out. Got some room. On the dribble, gives it up. Gave it up. 10 on the shot clock. Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I tell you, the whole fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
He takes it away. Kicks it out. He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Picks off the lazy pass. Goes up for two. Was that beautiful or what? Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick.
They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And the clock stopped with a foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play. Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
second one is no good.
I'm out. Starting to pull away here, Dick.
Coming inside.
For two.
Don't waste a lot of time. Foul right away.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. With the free one. He makes the front end of the one and one. Second one, good. It's a 10-point spread, Dick.
Yeah, but 10 points can't be spread too thin, Brad.
They're working around the arc with a deep shot from outside.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper.
Well, Dick, there's a look at the foul situation.
Well, you know, Brad, a lot of times the first team to the bonus will get the advantage. That means they play an aggressive basketball. It means they get to the charity stripe quicker and have an opportunity to rack up some easy points.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation so far.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble and in the stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line and out of bonus situations.
Makes the second shot.
They really need a score here to have a chance.
6 points is the difference.
Wow, do they need a basket badly, Brad? Momentum will decide it.
Rims out. They've left him completely alone.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Auburn is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.